I would like to put forth our position vis-à-vis Christianity, that Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith for its followers to believe in Jesus. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus. We are made to believe that Jesus Christ was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We believe in his miraculous birth, which many modern-day Christians do not believe today. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. And we believe that he gave life to the dead by God's permission, and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. As such, the Muslim and the Christian is going together. But the parting of the way takes place on three bases. Number one, the original sin. Number two, the divinity of Christ. And number three, the crucifixion. These are points of differences between the Muslims and the Christians.
You made a statement that Islam believes in the virgin birth of Christ, but does not that God does not beget nor is he begotten. Luke, the first chapter, the 34th and the 35th verse, explains the birth of Christ as the Holy Spirit overshadowing Mary and the power of the Most High pouring upon her. How do you explain this?
You see, Brother Swaggart has suggested during his talk that the Quran is a copy, a plagiarism of stories from the Bible. Now, let me give you this example here, a comparison between what is told in the scriptures and what is told in the Quran about the birth of Jesus, if I may. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of God, most gracious, most merciful. Wa is qalatil malaikatu ya Maryamu, behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allah astafaki wa taharaki wa astafaki ala nisa'il alameen, that God Almighty has chosen thee and purified thee, chosen thee above the women of all nations. This is the honor that is given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, in the Holy Quran, that she is a woman chosen above the women of all nations. Ya Maryam ibnuti li rabbiki wasjudi warka'i ma'ar raki'een. So, O Mary, worship thy Lord devoutly. Prostrate thyself and bow down in prayer with those who bow down. Dhalika min amba'il ghaibi nuhihi ilayka. This is part of the tidings of the things unseen which we reveal unto thee, O Muhammad, by inspiration. You were not with them when they cast lots with arrows as to which of them should be charged with the care of Mary, nor was thou with them when they disputed the point. I will not go into the full story, but if I may, I will have to do it tomorrow night. But the verses continue. Wa is qalatil malaikatu ya Maryamu, behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allaha yubashiruki bi kalimatin minhu, that God Almighty gives you glad tidings of a word from him. Ismuhul Masih, his name will be the Messiah, translated Christ. Isa ibn Maryam, Jesus the son of Mary, wajihan fi dunya wal akhirah, held in honor in this world and in the hereafter. Wa min al muqarrabin, and of the company of those nearest to God. What the Christian would say, sitting on the right hand of God. We say not physically, not geographically, but in stature, in spirituality, in the company of those nearest to God. Wa yukallimu an-nasa, and he will speak to the people, fil mahdi wa kahlun, in childhood and in maturity, wa min as-salihin, and he shall be of the company of the righteous. When this good news is given to Mary about the birth of a holy son, she says, qalat rabbi anna yakunu li waladun wa lam yamsasni bashar. She said, oh my Lord, how shall I have a son when no man has touched me? The angel says in reply, qala qadhalika Allahu yakhluqu ma yasha. So even so, Allah creates what he wills. وَإِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا, whenever he decrees a matter, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. So whenever he decrees a matter, he merely says to it, be and it is. This is the Muslim concept of the birth of Jesus. For God to create a Jesus without a human father, just like that. To create a million Jesuses without father, without mother, just like that. The biblical version, in comparison, I am suggesting, to Reverend Dankers, the head of the Bible Society in Johannesburg. I had gone there to buy an Indonesian Bible in Johannesburg, and he called me for tea, seeing this funny headgear of mine and this beard, that I was interested in Bibles. He called me into his office, and I explained this to him, which was something novel to him, something amazing to him, that I was speaking from my book. So he said, look, this and the Bible appears to me to be the same. I said, yes, on the face of it. On the face of it, we are both trying to say the same thing, that Jesus was created by a special miracle. But I said, when you compare them closely, the difference between the Quran and the Bible is chalk and cheese. I don't know whether the Americans understand this expression, chalk and cheese. The Canadians didn't, because they didn't know chalk, they knew crayon, crayon and cheese, which is not the same thing. Chalk and cheese is poles apart, worlds apart. The Quran says for God to create, he merely wills it and the thing comes into being. The Bible says, and the Holy Ghost, same question, how can this thing be when no man has touched me? Or I know not a man, meaning sexually. The Bible says, and the Holy Ghost will come upon thee, and the power of the Most High will overshadow thee. This gives that picture to the atheist and the agnostic to beat you with. How did the Holy Ghost come on Mary? How did the Almighty overshadow her, like a man doing to his wife? How? No, we know it doesn't mean that. But the language of the two. See, the Quranic language is for God to create, he wills it, and the thing comes into being. The biblical language is earthly. I said, between the two, I'm asking Reverend Dankers, which version would you be prepared to give to your daughter? The Quranic version of the birth of Jesus or the biblical version? And believe me, he bowed his head in shame, and he said, I would prefer to give the Quranic version to my daughter.
Does the glorious Quran state that the Holy Injil is guidance for all mankind?
No, the Holy Quran doesn't say that the Injil is a guidance for mankind. Nor does the Bible say that. You see, Jesus Christ, when he sent out his disciples on the mission of preaching and healing, he instructed them. He said, go ye not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not, but go ye rather unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. I want to know where the American Anglo-Saxons fit in as the Jews, the house of Israel. Then he's telling a Jewish woman, a Greek woman comes to him, wanting her daughter to be healed. So he turns his face away. She goes on the other side and she won't let him go. So the disciples say, help her, this woman is persistent. You know, like a drowning man clutching at straws, drowning women do the same. Heal her child. So Jesus says, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel, the Jews. So they say, help her. Jesus says, do not throw the bread of the children to the dogs. Who are the dogs? The Gentiles, you and me. Every other human being other than the Jews are dogs and pigs, according to Jesus, or according to your scripture. It says, Jesus says, do not throw that which is holy unto dogs. Do not throw pearls before swine, lest they turn and rend you. Who are the dogs and who are the swine? The Gentiles. So he says, do not throw the bread of the children to the dogs. The woman in desperation, her child's life is at stake. She says, Lord, Master, even the dogs have crumbs from the Master's table. So he said, give her the crumbs. Look, this is the scripture. Unfortunately, the scripture is not being quoted. The scripture, quote what Jesus said. I'd like to hear what Jesus said. Jesus says, not about this supposed idea that you just believe and you be saved. He said, verily, verily, I say unto you, except your righteousness exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, you shall by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. There's no heaven for you unless you are better than the Jew. And I'm asking, how can you be better than the Jew by not keeping the laws and the commandments? You answer that.